next man.
You've got that image of a Stafford. Don't look pretty. They are what they are. A simple animal.
Very rare you'll find a good Staffordshire Bull that wants to rip everything apart. It just knows in itself that it can do it if it needs to.
The Stafford wood fetches softness in any man out. You know, they're just tremendous. You can't ask for a better dog.
I'm very nervous that something might go wrong, because it is her first time. I just hope that she's going to be a good mother, that everything goes so well, you know.
Stop them across the board so far, but we're interested to know which way you're going next.
I'd like an H, please, Bob.
OK, to the left. What H is a two-syllable rhyming word?
Yeah, when I found out she was pregnant, it was jubilation. It was just unbelievable, because I've tried three times. I thought, you know, I just wasn't destined to breed a litter, you know.
It's just a dream come true now that everything's actually gone to plan, and it should be a really good birth, you know. Shouldn't be any problems. I set the shed up for myself and the bitch to be together out here, and away from the noises of the house and the other bitch, so we could be together out there in the quiet, so she could have her pups. I think I'm pretty prepared for the big day. This is an old cot which I've put together. It's to create a cave-like situation. I have a portable TV there for the nights I'll be spending here. I got some toweling to dry the pups. I got a scale to weigh the puppies. Some glucose to put in the bitch's water to give her extra energy. I've got my hot water bottles to put into the box to keep the puppies nice and warm should I need to take them away from the bitch.
What I'm actually looking for is a perfect Stafford. Looking for perfection. Another Stafford owner could turn around and just say, "Oh, that's a cracking dog." And everybody would look on it and say, "That is the perfect dog," you know.
Come here.
Morning, Roy.
Morning.
How are you?
Fine, thanks.
How's she?
Oh, she's good.
Hello, Cloud.
Good.
Put her up on the table, please. May I have the tail?
I decided to take my bitch for a scan because previously I hadn't had much luck breeding my older bitch because she had fading puppies the first time. Well, it's not only the waiting, it's knowing that everything is okay, whether she's going to have complications. And just generally, it's nice to know that everything is going okay.
4, 5, 6. There's a rugby scrum in here. There we have a head again.
Yeah.
And that head's got to be borne out between those two white lines there.
When my wife went for the scan, it seemed that all the doctors and nurses were around her. And I was more or less pushed out, you know, my nose was pushed out, that I wasn't involved.
Oh, good.
Okay, and the next. next thing that I want to see is whether all the pups are about
my
the
wife
same
thinks
size.
That I'm more excited about the birth of these puppies than I was when my son was born.
What you'd expect on a big litter.
Mm. I think that's true.
You're trying to stop the stretch marks, are you?
Yes, that's right. Yeah.
And are you going to be a midwife?
Yes, I am, actually, yeah.
Yes, we got everything ready?
Yes, the shed is all done out and nice and warm, yeah. My loyalties were divided when the baby came along, between the puppy and the baby. My wife was mostly with the baby, and I'd have the bitch by me, just so she wouldn't be jealous, you know, because it was pretty hard on her. Somebody else having all the fuss, you know, and she was thrown out of the limelight, basically. It feels as if I'm a father myself, really, because when the puppies are born, when it's time for them to leave, around 6-7 weeks, I'll be, you know, be a bit worried where they go. I hope they go to good homes. I suppose it's like children going to school, really. Should they go to a bad school or a good school? I think I owe it to the bitch to stay out with her. I mean, I took her to the stud dog and, well, I'm going to be sleeping out with the bitch, you know, and I think she'd want me out there. Definitely. Once you have a Stafford and you really know the temperament and kindness and courage the dog has got, that's the only dog for you. It's just, you've been bitten, you know.
These are puppies were born now 7 days ago. This is the one dog that I like the best so far. I'm hoping, like all showers, dog showers and dog breeders, but to potential champion. As far as pets go, the most lovable dog you can have. Faithful and everything. But if anybody, any dog do attack it or whatever, it'll stand its grounds and not run away like a wimp, which not many staffs would do that anyway. It's like when I was working in nightclubs as a bouncer. The aggression would never come out until somebody else started it. And saying in a way, that is the temperament of the Stafford. It's really good until it's get pushed too far, and then it can do the business. Stafford used to have a bad name. There's a big scare on now with this pit bull business. They see a Stafford going down the street and they say, oh, it's a pit bull. They're completely different dogs altogether. The temperament in them is completely different. My biggest fear is for my puppies, although I vet the owners, that they could end up in a dog's home. Often I'm called in to go up to the dog's home and pick a dog up and take it to a new owner, or perhaps identify it as a Stafford. But it breaks your heart when you see the other dogs in there, what's going to be put down the next day, the same day, or even 5 days later.
One Staffordshire Bull, he's only been in here 5 days now, and he's in very good condition.
Yeah, he's been well looked after, hasn't he? It's a pity, really, I think we just let him roam the streets.
Well, they sometimes abandon them when they get like 7 to 12 months, because they don't have a lot of chewing in the house. And the wife gets fed up, kicks the dog out the back garden, where it's not fenced in, and away it goes.
Come on, mate, come on.
Comes before women or anything. They're more trusting than any human being, you know. And that's, you know, not just saying that, they are. The dogs will stick by you, like, you know. I know people have always called me stupid because I let the dogs run the house, but my dogs are my life, and that's it. But the dogs they've had, they're still puppies until they're old. I don't see the change in the dog at all. He still wants to play. Every dog they've had wanted to play all the time. The bitches, once they get over 12 months, they just don't seem to want to play so much. The spirit is still there for another dog, though. A couple of girlfriends I've had, one in particular came here to live with me. She wanted me to build kennels, which I'd done. I wasn't very happy about putting my dogs outside mine, HS. But I thought, well, I got on with her and she's a real good girl. We're still very close friends now. But I couldn't put the kennels up overnight. It took a matter of weeks. But it wasn't fast enough for her, so she went. And I'm sorry, you know, the dogs have been in ever since. So whoever I meet, as if ever I meet everybody in the future, they got to accept the dogs. And the dogs live in the home. And that's it.
In the tropics, mangroves are moving out into the sea, gathering mud and building new territory for land-living creatures. Even in the mouths of rivers, where fresh water, laden with sediment, mingles with the salt water of the sea, new land is being created of a sort.
When I'm by myself, she gets up on the settee.
I'm in an estuary.
We watch the TV.
In the west of England. And you might think that this mud is not the most attractive stuff in which to live. Certainly, any animals that do live in it have to face some severe problems.
What I hope for, same as any breeder, I could end up in Crufts. Even getting to Crufts is good enough to actually win Crufts, the best in breed. Well, that's my dream anyway.
Welcome to the Swansea Staffordshire Terrier Ringcraft Club. We are about to start with our training. All dogs out on the mat, please. Okay, stand your dogs up then, as if you're in the show. Instructors will come and show you. I'll just come round with the mirror to put you right. Mirror, Jack.
Once a month, I go to the dog hunting class, and the idea is to teach newcomers in the breed, as well as old ones, how to present the dog in shows.
Happy with that?
Actually walking the dog.
Right.
We teach them how to stand the dog, to present the dog in front of the judge.
Use the line again, key starter. Hold underneath the chin firm. Use the front line.
My idea of a perfect Stafford is a lean, mean fighting machine.
It's her first time. She's
I actually want to see it like a bodybuilder coming in.
When she stands correctly, give her a lot of praise. Yeah. Stroke and give her a hell of a lot of praise. Yeah. Not quiet, nice and loud, and she can understand. The back legs are gone in again, Keith.
I come to the land. I love you. Tell me, do you love me? I'm confessing that I need you, honest I do. Oh, baby, need you every moment. In your eyes I read such strange things, baby. But your lips deny their true love. Will your answer really change things, making them blue? Making them blue. I'm afraid someday you'll leave me. And can't we still be friends? But anyway, I'm confessing that I love you all again.
Where the Staffordshire Bull Terrier and a good boxer comes together is the fact that both are willing to take extremes of pain and still come back to win, even though if they know that they ain't gonna win. We need to have the fighting spirit in a Stafford, because for the main reason, if you haven't got the fighting spirit, you haven't got a Stafford, because you don't just lose the fighting spirit, you would also lose the old character where the love, which is why people keep them, for the love, the friendship and their loyalty. You'd lose it all. You wouldn't just lose one little part of it, like, oh, chuck this out the window. You'd lose all of it. I figure Staffordshire Bull has a gentle-eyed nature in the respect that they're very loving, and a lot of people who've seen Staffordshire Bulls with the owner would think, oh, well, oh, that's nothing, you know, I would burgle that house, but I wouldn't want to be the person trying to invade an house with a Staffordshire Bull or attacking an owner, because you definitely see the bad side of them then.
I've been a professional boxer for 16, 17 months. I hope to fight for the British title within the next year. You've got to be dedicated training. Obviously, you've got to be able to take punishment as well as give it anyone on this earth and hit people as long as they're not getting it back. But it takes a game animal to fight when it's losing and it knows it's got no chance of winning. Every fight I have, I'm never afraid of who I'm fighting or if I get hurt. I'm just afraid of if I lose.
A Stafford is very determined in no matter what you're doing, like even just playing about. If you see the concentration on them and they gotta win all the time, no matter, like, if they won't give up, they could be virtually collapsed playing about anything and they won't give up.